What's up, everyone? Just a short notice, I'm giving away 12 tickets to the $88 main event on Natural 8. It's 20k guaranteed, usually has around 5k up top, so pretty decent tournament. 12 tickets for you guys. All you have to do is click the link in the description, just takes a couple of seconds. And yeah, get involved. Enjoy the video. We have such a chill stack, you know, but this is gonna be a pretty simplifying table. As long as I don't have aces, I'm folding. At least bubble that is. I'm pretty sure, like, let's say he open jams and I have kings, I would fold here. If the bubble was 2x, I think then we would call kings for sure, but with the 3.6x bubble, I think these hands just become a fold. That's my guess. How are you doing today, Tom? Classic music all the time these days. 2 days in a row now. Come on, let's not go with all the time. Yesterday's streams and stream and today's. I'm not sure, I'm just reading the mood. It's pretty. Oh, my back is just so fucked. I'm just set up right now. I even fixed my setup to be higher, but I don't know, it doesn't really work. Down here, I'm like limping a bit. Just because the SPR is so weird and not in my favor. Not the SPR, that I'm short-side with the bounty. There we have it, guys. I'm pretty sure this is just an open fold. It's still a different story if you open jam or if you actually call a jam. But, yeah. Once again, I think the min cash is just so incredibly big that it doesn't make much sense. But I'm going to review that hand, obviously. It's pretty interesting. Because it's tough. Like, it's clear that we shouldn't call a jam with ace-king. Like, that's 100% clear. It's really easy to understand. But it's tough to figure out which hand we should be open jamming and which not. Like, same spot now with pocket nines. These are actually two crazy spots where I'm really unsure about what to do. I'm just going to go with the fold once again. I can't believe it, man. I just can't believe how bad. Like, fucking Winamax, it's unbelievable, dude. And then to check 8, guy raises 10-7 suited, and then obviously 10 the root. I'm whining so much on that side. That's insane. Winamax makes me whine so much. Incroyable. But these are just, like, every hand is just so tilting, you know? Nice go, right? I thought about streaming in German back in the days, but these days just too much of my followership is speaking English, so I'm not gonna stream. Alright, there's the aces that I talked about. Okay. I mean, now we're even calling somebody ISOs and hope. I mean, if I lose this, I might not cash. So that would be obviously absolutely terrible. Good luck, boys. Don't do it to me, ISOs. Don't you do it to me. Don't you dare doing this to me. Don't you fucking dare. Oh my god, come along. I mean, if he calls, it's better for me because it's less likely that... Like, I need to lose versus both for it to be an awful spot. You know, and obviously even more chips than average. All right, good luck. Yeah. Woo! $360 bubble, guys. Woo! Let's play some poker. Get some more ladders. Holy shit. We all in on Winamax, East Queen. It's time to shine. Yeah, I'll fix the light in 1 second. Alright, get it through. That's pretty surprising given my big bounty. We have another jam with ace 9. I just want my head to be in the shadow, rest should be in the sun. Good luck, ace 9 now. Let's hope he just has ace 8 deuce. I mean, they should be icing so wide with my bounty. Alright, we have the best hand. Hold! Yeah! We fucking hold, dude. Let's go. 47k. Nice triple up. Nice, nice triple up. Feels good, man. Let's go, boys. We also made the money on the final table. Guaranteed $360. Decent ladders ahead of us, so let's do it one step at a time for the win. I want that win so bad. I need that win. Nice. Bluff got somebody. Bro, your voice is like a mixture of Michael Jackson and Jesus. And Hitler, I guess, because of the German accent. Would. Can catch first hours of your stream now, but will always have to sleep early since I work on my thesis right now. Playing cash games every night, MTs on Sundays. Sounds good. Good luck on your thesis. Are you done? Is that like the last step you think you have to finish to complete college? Or university? Nice, Chrissy Bauer. Danke, Mann. Ich bin Köln-Fan. Aber Düsseldorfer sind trotzdem willkommen hier. Viel Spaß in Venedig, Mann. Oh, Baby. Close power threes. But with my stack, I think we just have to grab the bounty opportunities when they're available. We would be icing sixes plus here anyhow. Oh, shit. Good luck. We also get it in really good on natural 8 with ace king versus ace queen and ace jack. We need a 3. We need a 3. But we win the sideboard. And obviously, you know, lose to ace queen. No surprise. And over here, we don't really lose many chips on the hand. So it's all good. And we also had a shot at a bounty. So, all cool. Still a 40k there, 14 or 15, and obviously we had a good shot at picking up a bounty. Ooh, big all-ins coming up here. We're just gonna sweat this a little bit as well. Wow, easy life. This king is an open shove regardless of the min cash, lol. Nope, the min cash obviously plays a huge role in determining if you want to jam or not. But thanks for bad input as usual. Twitch chat, never change, please. Yeah, I'm gonna run the spot later and then I know it. Limp is also fine if you balance it, lol. Yep, you have no idea what you're talking about, dude. So when you have no idea, either you take your approach of just saying a lot of stupid things or you just shut up. And I would strongly recommend to shut up. Instead. Because I don't know. But I'm gonna run this spot and figure the math out behind it. But yeah. Like, why do you try to give advice, man? Like, there's no way you're playing the stakes that I'm playing. And if you play them, I really, really hope. Actually, I hope you're playing my stakes. But yeah. Just. Like, why? Why do you think you're in the spot to give advice? Like, why? How, where does it come from? Limping is also not fine. I mean, obviously, if they do play passively against my limp, yeah, then it could be fine, but it's unlikely to be the case. Ace 5 suited, we jam for 6 blinds, pretty standard. I mean, more than just standard, it's like such a snap fist bump jam. That flop, though, yeah, always a sweat. Ah, the min cash is just so incredibly important there that I don't think ace, king, and nines should be doing much. I could be wrong, obviously. But I think it's fine. Ace. 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 That works. What up, Steven? I'm gonna listen to Henry over Twitch chat. I'm just a guy that tries to figure out the math, you know, on the go. We can review it after the stream today if you guys want. Depends how many tapes I have open, but I will definitely review that. Super interesting. It's not a spot that comes up very often, obviously, with like, if the min cache was smaller, we can jam these hands, but since the min cache is so big, wow. Okay, let's go, guys. Come on. Winamax, six of the money. This could give us a big stack and obviously $161 bounty. Let's fucking do this. We also have a bounty spot on the 109, 15 big blind jam, easy call with A7, can we hold? That's a great start. Here's ace king as well, we need to fade some. Alright, we win here, can we hit a diamond? Oh, we chop it with ace king. That would be fucking insane if we win with ace king versus ace king. So we got half the bounty, 40 euros, we're up to 48k, obviously sucks that he wakes up with a hand, but it's fine. Over here, 40k now with that hold, that was absolutely clutch. And we're raising this guy's limp. Let's do it, guys, let's fucking do it. We also had a KO on the final table. All right. So we're guaranteed $440 now. Nichi, it's different though. Oh, five. No. It's the same network but different skins. So there's some things on NetRate that are different on GG Poker, like deposit bonuses, and some tournaments might be different and stuff like that. But yeah, lots of things are similar. Yeah, the giveaway I do is only on NetRate, not on, yeah, not anywhere else. We'll finish in November, hopefully. Nice. I don't know. I don't think America's card room is rigged, but I obviously don't know it. I'm just gonna fold here, and we got queens now. So find two tables, 12 left, 9 paid. Be a good spot to double up once more. I think like MTTs are easy. It's easier to make money in MTTs than cash games. But I think overall, if you play the higher stake cash games versus the high stakes MTTs, you probably make more money playing the high stakes cash games if you get into some good games there. Come on, somebody has sent my bounty here, eh? It's a 200 euro buy-in, so I'm just gonna see it. Should be more regulars than recreationals. I have no idea who that guy is. Interesting turn. Yo, hope he pairs with the 23-month reserve. Thank you very much, dude. Welcome back home. My dude! Speaking about natural aid, baby. Alright, I'm gonna fire a third pot on the river here, just for value. From like king 6 here. Maybe a 5. Oh man, this fine table is so interesting. I think we're just folding ace check again, because these two guys have 3 big blinds. He folds. Still a decent pot. Oh. So yeah, folded ace check here, once again, looks really ridiculous for 16 blinds, but we have two guys with 3 and 4 big blinds. And these guys, I think, are more important than my open or my jam there. I would just open jam there. But I'm going to review it once again. But I did a bunch of math with ICM lately, and I feel a bit more confident. And I think this is one of these spots where we should just be folding. No action with the kings. Too bad. But yeah, thanks, Brian. Welcome back. Yeah, I think having a decree is really important. I agree. I would like to have a decree, but whatever. Don't a Kruger effect regarding Twitch chat? Never heard of that. It's like people not... Yeah, I have no idea what it is. Oh shit, yeah, you guys from the Netherlands are not allowed to play there anymore. I've read that. Super weird, right? Brian, this tournament was fucking insane today. Like, look at the bubble, man. Over here, I check out the flop, check the turn. H Jack versus 3-6 and hits the straight, too bad, no KO. Alright, well, let's just focus on this. The guy fires the turn again. Puts me in a weird spot. Sure, I'll just give it up. I mean, this guy has one big blind. I don't think I can do anything here until he busts. I think these would just be bad jams. Because they're obviously profitable chip EV, but we might not get a $160 ladder that we have pretty much locked up. And obviously, there's other people that might bust as well. Really interesting final table. I'm going to review the whole thing just because it's so absurd. This tournament got 60 entries, so a really small field. But big first place prize. Yeah, interesting spot. So, like, ace king was interesting, nines was interesting, ace check was interesting, and the ace7 suited the cutoff also. Because it's always complicated. Like, I'm much more confident facing a jam in these spots because I know I have to fold everything. But figuring out what hands I should be open jam with is much more complicated, for me at least, because I don't know how much fold equity. Like, obviously, we have fold equity, but how much that is and how that affects our jamming range. So, hope this guy just busts. So I can play some more hands. Alright, come on, A6. Nice. Guaranteed $600 now. It's good cash already. Now we have to wait for this guy. Hopefully he calls. Come on. Come on. Too bad. He has been opening so wide. We saw like 63 suited. I'm going to rejam here. Because he also stacked up a bit. And I do think we have a bunch of fold equity here. So yeah. I think it's fine. It's obviously not amazing. But he's been opening so wide that I think it's pretty good, to be honest. Nice, yeah, we pick up so many chips there. I'm gonna review this one as well. I think it's fine because he opens like 80% of hands and folds like 60% to the jam. But it's obviously not ideal with these two stacks. But yeah, I don't know. I said we're gonna run a bunch of spots after this. Great to see the fold. Ace check fold question mark. Nitty. Yeah, I'm interested to review the whole thing. I know, I worked a bit with ICMizer and it just fucks up your mind. Okay, guys, we have everything. This is gonna be a tough one to lose. And yeah, we haven't crushed and hold. Nice, 215 bounty, another one. And I realize how tight you have to be. Like, so much more tighter than I thought I would have to be, so yeah. It's just because two guys had three big blinds that fold the ES check, you know? Could be wrong once again. Same as this one, like, fucking close, dude. I think it's fine. But it could just be a fold as well. Great to see you get through. Yeah, makes sense. Gonna defend here. Check fold. All right, this one is going in every time. GL. God, at this fine table, man. I love these two fine tables. Little 530 bounty today, yep. Got pretty unlucky in the spot. I think this is just a fold. With him folding and having five big blinds again. These could all be chances, is that I could be totally wrong here, but we're gonna review it afterwards. ICM's pretty complicated and complex. So we'll see. Yeah. That was a pretty ridiculous hand. Somebody opens. Recreational flats. I squeeze with nines. Original opener folds. The guy that flatted calls me. Flop comes down 7-7 deuce. The guy pot leads into me. I have like 2x pot, right? So he pot leads. I rejam my nines on 7-7 deuce. He snap calls and has king 7 offsuit for flop trips. So not only did he flat and open with king 7 offsuit, called a 3 with king 7 offsuit, flop trips, and then pot leaded his trips in a huge pot already. So it was just a fucking disgusting way to bust. Yeah, I would agree, girl. I think that's definitely a thing. Because the more you know about subject, the less you realize you know about it. Good luck is nine. Let's hold. Jack, spade. Fuck. It's annoying. So yeah, I think that's definitely a thing, yeah. That makes a lot of sense to me. Because the more I know, learn about poker, the more I realize how many things I don't know yet. I would prefer a fold here, for sure. Nice. Gonna rejam the Eastern suited with three of the money. Good luck. Nine. GG. 20 euro bounty. We probably cashed for, yeah, made 24 euros. Park jump. GG. Oh shit, I totally forgot about the. Fuck. Bounty. 192 bounty. I need to play it right now. There we go. Thanks all of the evening. Yeah, definitely. I think everybody is like that. But it obviously makes sense as well. It's just, I don't know, I just would never give somebody tips anymore. Like, that is clearly bad at something. Like, it's a different thing, I think, if you just are like, oh man, this seems, like, if you talk with your friends about it, but like actively stating it against the guy being like, oh, that was terrible, even without knowing anything, was fun. Wow. He just raised folded the 6 big blind stack. That's just the thing that, what the fuck? That makes me so tilted, because that is not a thing. It's absolutely not a thing. Like, not even close to raise fold to a 6 big blind rejam. And obviously hurts me, like, a lot. Like, he just, holy shit, he won so many chips just now. What the fuck? I mean, what the fuck? These guys get insane odds. 4. Damn it. It's pretty bad. Now I'm 5th out of 5th. Call. Nice. Hard. It works as well. Now he's really short. We just gotta wait for him to bust. God, I'm so excited to review this final table. So interesting. Fold. Let's knock him out. Can I just fold here because he's never bluffing? Probably. Nice. Okay, that's the KO. Four to four now, so we can go with it. Ah, please fold, dude. You've done some raise folds like this before. Let's do it again. Come on, just do it. You're always behind here. Holy shit, these raise folds that the guy is doing is, it's insane. It's definitely a note. All right, let's fucking win this thing. What are we guaranteed right now? Fourth place for 800 bucks. Not that bad. Let's hope the guy to my right busts. Is the blinds go up again? Yeah, exactly. So you just go to the thing, and then for everything you do, you get one entry, and for every entry, that's one chance to win the giveaway, pretty much. So obviously, the more of the things in the giveaway thing that you complete, the higher your chances to win the whole thing. I think with the gutshot, we got to call one here. I'm just gonna bet here, because if he has nothing, he's just gonna fold, and I can rep 4x as well. So I just hope he has nothing. Wow, that jam doesn't make any sense. Might have had a flush draw. But yeah, it's not a spot we should ever jam. I like my bluff. I think we played the hand fine. Please call big blind. That would be amazing. Oh my god, let's. No. Fuck, that would have been great. That would have been great, guys. Four big blind Lero with the Queen 8. Gonna 3x, hopefully the big blind folds. Nope. All right, that's a good flop. Good luck, guys. Hold. Nice. Let's do it. Let's fucking do it. Now we cover him again. So we gotta be a bit careful. What an interesting man, I love this final table. I love these turbo final tables. It's so fun to play because the ICM is just so interesting. Oh my god, what? Ace! Oh no! Even it's a jack. Too late, too little. Fuck. I'm from Germany, but I live in New Zealand right now. And a UK resident. Yeah, I'm gonna call here. Gonna regen this if he opens. Blind versus blind is obviously an easy jam for 7 blinds. Nice. Definitely prefer the fold there. It's not that we dominate a lot of hands that call us. And I just want to pick up free chips. I think this is a fine jam as well. Whoops. Nice. 10 big blinds. Holy shit. Big stack Lero. Wer bottet the money in the 19 Bounty und Stars as well? Give me that walk. I wonder if these are like profitable regems against him, because he literally opens everything. Okay, never mind. Against that size. Oh, baby. Went for the 3 with ace 9 suited, and look at this flop. So he doesn't have 7-8 suited, that would suck. This is a pretty poor runout, to be honest, but I think it is SPR, I'm just jamming. We also have pocket eights four-handed here. Can we get another jam through? Nice. Easy all-in. And we get the fold. Still a good pot. Still chilling on 10 BB. Thanks, Fold Kings. Alright, he's down to 200k now. That's good for us. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, I take a walk. Sure, sure thing. No need to gamble. I just fold. Man, this is getting really interesting now with the stacks. One double up and we're chipping this shit. Good luck. An important double up opportunity with kings. Blinds went up again on the final table. I have 10 big blinds, even though I just got the jam through. Wow, that's a nice hand to see. That's a terrible flop to see. It's a great turn. Great river. Let's go 40k in the big 50 euro. He's all in now. I mean, stacks are like really shallow. With the 24k big blind. This could be interesting. Actually, I have a plan. If he opens, yeah, okay, easy call off blind, best blind. Good luck, boys. Oh, we get the walk. That's amazing. Thank you. I don't want to call it there. We have to because we cover him, but I still prefer not to. Makes it easy again. All right, this could be it. Does he finally bust? Yep. We're down to 3. Guaranteed 1,200. There's still 1,600 to play for with 3 really short stacks, but I feel comfortable in my play. And obviously, decisions shouldn't be that tough at a stack size. Oh, baby. I like it. We want these guys to battle as much as possible and knock each other out. Nice. Ship the walk. I'm gonna catch up with Chad after this, guys, but a three-handed takes away lots of attention right now. Gonna limp to check this suited. Check the flop. We have no connectivity whatsoever here, so I'm just gonna use this as a check folding hand. He wins that one. It's close. Like how he just like min raises over the limbs. Oh, come on, have it one time. Oh my god, check! Check! 8! Oh, it's still fine for us, it's still fine because now he is 40k and we might get the ladder. So that's still, like, that's amazing that they clash with these two big hands against each other. I have to fold everything now. If he jams, yeah. Come on, win it. Win it. 6-7, let's do it. Spade. Spade. Fuck. Oh my god, this is so brutal for me now. I mean, but this guy is overly aggressive, so he hopefully busts soon. It's a clear, clear fold. Four big blinds for him. What did I jam here on the button? Let's already think about it. Certainly not this one. He should jam a shit ton here. Don't give him the walk. Please don't do it. Alright, that's fine with me. Like, he loses a fourth of his deck there by just folding, so that's good. At least I have good... I'm getting good hands right now, because I have clear decisions with this one, with these ones. And if I had, like, an ace 8 suited there, I would hate my life. Once again, easy decision. This is pretty nice. Let's see what we get on the button. Alright, easy decisions. He's down to three bigs. Hold. Yeah! We heads up, boys. We made it. We made it. 1800. We fought our way into a heads up match with six big blinds. Look at all the fucking letters we got. Let's see if we can make a sick comeback here, but I'm already more than happy with my result given the stack I had in this tournament, man. We made some really ICM aware plays here. This is a fun final table for me. Let's hope we can close it out. 9-4 for seven big blinds goes into the muck. Damn, that feels amazing, dude. That feels like a victory for me right now. Queen 4, 6 big blinds is probably just a fold. That's a slight call. Good luck. That's a bad hand to see. Let's see a 4-4-4-4-4. GG. Oh, he already hit the check. Never mind. That is an amazing second place finish. I certainly take that one. GG, boys. 1800. Feels good, man. And the 1-9 turbo.